thank you everyone for coming tonight. I would like to call this meeting of the Somerset Berkley Regional School Committee to order at 6:30 p.m. due notice having been posted. Roll call. Mr. Ghilarducci?
Here.
Mr. Kelly?
Here.
Ms. White?
Here.
Mr. Gagliardi?
Here.
Mrs. Rothwell?
Here.
Mr. Camara?
Here.
In addition, we have with us this evening our interim superintendent, Thomas Lynch, our recording secretary, Michelle Cross here, our director of business and finance, Mark Furtado, and director of information technology, Raymond Necras. Ask everyone to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The first item on the agenda is to consider minutes of the July 8th, 2013 meeting. Those minutes were prepared by our recording secretary. The executive session minutes were referred to legal counsel for review, and we haven't had a response, so I'd entertain a motion to defer consideration of those minutes till our next meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Camara, seconded by Mrs. Gagliardi. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next item is communications. There are none. Is there any public input at this time? The absence of public input under old business. Is there an update from the Somerset School Committee, Mr. Camara?
We'll be meeting tomorrow night, obviously. We'll have a joint meeting with you all for the regional committee for Whitson's handle some business. And we've started interviews for the Chase principal, so those are ongoing. Also working on filling some of the other vacant positions right now. That's about it at this time.
Thank you. And Mr. Ghilarducci,
yep.
You have some items.
Yes, I have a couple. At the Coyle Cassidy graduation, Brittany DeRocio and Deanna Pacheco were recipients of $5,000 scholarships from the Grand Lodge of Basins in Massachusetts. So, we wish them good luck and good fortune where they will be attending college.
They're both Berkeley residents?
Berkeley residents, yes. Beautiful girls, too.
Was there anything else?
No, that's it.
Okay. Well, I would like to take, since Mr. Ghilarducci had the floor, to congratulate him and his wife in celebrating their 46th wedding anniversary. It's today, actually.
We celebrated last night, so I can make the meeting.
That's right. They celebrated it yesterday so that he could be here at the meeting tonight. We want to congratulate you.
Thank
46
you.
Years of marital bliss. Next item is technology task force update.
We have not had a meeting since our last regional school committee meeting. We're still awaiting the draft report from TechEdge, so we'll be forwarding that one.
Next item is to finalize the meeting schedule for 2013-2014 year, and there's a copy of the list of meeting dates that was provided, I believe, at the last meeting. Does anyone have any comments regarding the proposed schedule?
I have a conflict with the 9th of September.
Okay.
I mean, if you have enough to make a form, that's fine, but I won't be able to attend. That's my anniversary. It was significant.
All right. Any other dates that problematic?
I'm in handbell choir, and I would have difficulty with January 21 and February 18, because we rehearse on Tuesday nights. That's with the Stone Church in Rainham.
Those, I believe, are, the reason those meetings were scheduled on Tuesday is due to the fact there's a holiday on Monday, and the Berkley School Committee meets on Monday, so we have limited dates available in those months. Any other comments on the schedule? Then I suggest I'd entertain a motion to approve all the dates with the exception of September 9th, 21st, January 21st, and February 18th, and look at the calendar in the interim and see if we can come back with suggested alternatives for those meetings. Is there a motion to that effect?
So moved.
Motion made by Ms. White and seconded by Mrs. Rothwell. Any further discussion? We have some further discussion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next item is personnel issues. As the committee is aware, there are several personnel issues, some of which involve the Somerset K-8 School Committee, where there are joint positions involved. We have a meeting of the chairs, vice chairs, and superintendent scheduled for 5 p.m. tomorrow at the North Elementary School in advance of our joint meeting at 6:30. I don't know, Mr. Lynch, if there's anything to report that's appropriate to report in public session, or we should wait until?
We should probably wait on most of them. I have had probably 8 discussions with Mr. Medeiros about these positions. We met a couple times last week. We met again today for about a half hour, an hour or so. As far as these Somerset Berkley High School personnel, new hirings, thus far we have hired 2 science teachers. Well, one will be hopefully signed in the morning. We've hired a math teacher, we've hired a special needs teacher, we've hired a Spanish teacher and a special needs teacher. We did offer a contract to a moderate special needs teacher with the hopes of keeping a program or bringing back a program to the district. We were unsuccessful matching a contract that was close to the one he's receiving from the districts he's at now. So he withdrew. We're hoping to have some more strong candidates for that position. But thus far we have had very successful signings. And again, I'm meeting with a young gentleman tomorrow afternoon.
And just for clarification, the special needs position that you filled is something other than the position that we're talking about to address the 4 new students who are coming in September.
Yes, that the position that we have hired a young woman is for an inclusion type of classroom. This would be a moderate special needs classroom where it's substantially different program from the from a regular classroom. And if we're successful in hiring this person, it would save the region probably $120,000 approximately.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And I just wanted to point out, these positions that we're filling are vacant positions. They're not newly created positions.
Yes, they are vacant positions. They're not newly created positions.
Okay. So are there any other questions? Okay. Thank you. I hope we'll be able to make some significant progress when we meet tomorrow afternoon, and then perhaps be able to discuss the issues with the Somerset School Committee joint meeting tomorrow at 6:30.
I think we'll make successful progress tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening. Mr. Maderis and I have, again, we have met several times and we're on the same page with all of the items. Or the, all of the personnel, I should say.
Very good. All right, next item, budget and financial matters, budget transfer requests.
None for 14, Mr. Chairman. As we explained at the last meeting, we have executed all of those purchases that you had approved. We're in a about a $50,000 surplus after those purchases. In addition, we had about 130 return from FY12 encumbrances on the expense side. So the ultimate end of year position for the region, despite there being approximately $400,000 in unbudgeted needs this year, is going to be about a $180,000 surplus.
Next item, consider $3.6 million renewal and $1.4 million new money borrowing to cover project cash flow needs on a school construction project. Treasurer Lindsay Albanaz to make a presentation on those issues. I believe you've handed us two documents. Perhaps we could go through those first.
I try to give you all this every time we do a new borrowing, just so you can kind of see the picture as to what we're outstanding right now. So we do have a $3.6 million bond anticipation note due August 7th of 2013. So if you look at the second page, which has the pink line and the block in it, we decided, our fiscal advisor is advising us to borrow an additional $1.4 million on top of that to make it an even five, just to get us, hopefully, through the end of November, through the November, so we have enough liquidity to pay any work that's done through November 30th of 2013. Again, that all depends on if the projected expenditures are in line. If they're more than that, we might have to borrow more earlier. That's just using the projected expenditure column figures that the project manager had given us. We did ask them to give us an updated cash flow projection, so we're hoping that they'll give us that in the next couple weeks or so we can exactly see where we're at as far as what's been billed versus what they projected to be building, to have billed as of this date. I did add a column. The fifth column in is the difference cumulative. So you can see the cumulative projected expenses of $34,904,662 versus the actual cumulative expenses of $29,755,920, the difference of approximately $5.1 million less than the projected amounts. That might just be a billing issue. Doesn't mean that it's behind, it's just a cash flow figure. So I just wanted to fill the school committee in on those figures and kind of let you know how the project's done. The project's going on cash flow statement. And then I also supplied some MSBA actual reimbursement figures for you, so you can see that they've, if we include the June bills that you're going to approve tonight and we submit that for reimbursement, and we hopefully get what we anticipate getting from MSBA, it will be about $800 million so far that's been reimbursed from the MSBA.
18 million?
Yep, it's the 18, it's the number next to the yellow block. That's the cumulative number. And that'll get us through June 30th, 2013. Tonight's bill schedule are the bills, the last batch of bills for fiscal year 13. So if we include those in here, that's where we're at this point. And I also gave you some percentage breakdown as to what they're actually reimbursing us for is on a percentage basis. And there are some ineligible costs that they will not reimburse us on, and we can go into detail on that later if you prefer. But this is just kind of a snapshot as to what the projected expenditures are, what we've been reimbursed, and the borrowing figures. So you can see, if you go down to November 2013, that's probably about the month that we're going to be running a little short on liquidity and needing to borrow more money at that time.
Okay.
on this form, that column in bold under borrowing, are those the separate vans that we've approved to date? And then
actually, they're just to, they're new ones. They're not including any renewals that we've done. So like, you'll see tonight's is 1.4 million. You're not seeing the 3.6 added to it.
Okay.
So this
That's
is cumulative, what we've borrowed and, you know, new money, essentially.
Okay. So we anticipate possibly going out again in November at this point for a...
Yeah, it kind of depends, because we're borrowing on a short-term basis. It's, we don't have a bulk long-term bond out there that we can kind of just, you know, use at will. Because the interest rates are so low right now, we're just kind of taking advantage of them in short-term borrowing as much as we can. Obviously, those fluctuate with market rates, so we might have to revisit that in January and February and see if long-term is our better option. But for now, we just kind of keep an eye on the cash flow and kind of decide as we go what we need and if the interest rates are good enough.
And we can't go for long-term borrowing until we have two sets of audited financials.
Yes, the auditors are coming out August 26th to start the FY13 audit, and I anticipate it, I'm hoping it'll be done by no later than the end of October, at the latest, very latest.
Sure.
Last month we authorized the 3.6 million, correct?
No, the 6 million.
The 6 million?
The 3.6 is what we owe. This coming August 7th, so in conjunction with paying that off, we're going to borrow it and also another 1.4 on top of it to essentially be borrowing 5 million. But only 1.4 will be considered new money.
What did we authorize last time? You're saying we authorized 6 million last
time?
Yes,
the 6 million, above the 1.4.
Okay. And what's, did something change that we could do another 1.4 million the next, in a month?
No,
the
we,
last
just,
time?
We just kind of needed the 6 million to get us through the summer. Only get us through June and July, and then to get us through November, we decided, you know, upon the renewal of the 3.6, we should just throw in another additional on top of that, so we don't have to do another borrowing, you know, in September or October.
And so the total right now is 12.4 million?
If that tonight's means... goes through, the total will be 19.8.
And you said 18 million has been reimbursed.
Yes, out of 29.7 million, 18 million has been reimbursed.
And do we know when the next disbursement is going to be?
Well, they usually, about 3 weeks after the school committee approves the bills, I submit them. I pay them the day after the school committee meeting. So I can't submit for them until we've paid them and actually put the check.
Okay.
And I know that you need to wait for a form for the building committee for this Thursday's meeting. So if that all goes well, I'll pay them Friday, submit for Friday, and it's usually 2 to 3 week turnaround time to get the money back.
Okay, that's fine.
But we already got the May reimbursement the last week of June, so this is the only one that's kind of, we have no outstanding ones coming in at this moment.
So the reimbursements have been coming in timely?
Yes.
So, as you said, although the billing is slightly behind what the projected cash flow needs were, I would imagine that when the estimate of cash flow needs was provided to us originally, it was done on the legal side to be sure that we didn't run short in any particular month. So, it's not probably not surprising and not an indication of anything being behind schedule that we're that the actual payments are slightly below what the projections were, and as we're all aware, this is these are to meet the cash flow to pay our unreimbursed portion of the project as it's been going along now for about a year, and also to cover the monthly requisitions until we're actually reimbursed by the MSBA. So
I just want to add the cash on hand column, the very last column, includes expected MSBA reimbursements. So I don't want you to think that it's this plus whatever they're going to give us back. We're kind of including that in the money coming in, so we're not included on the cash flow statement. I just wanted to clarify that.
This new band that we're looking, the new band, which is 1.4 million, is expected to be at just shy of 1% interest?
Yes. It's the highest short-term one we've seen since we've been borrowing.
And when you renew the 3.6 million, you might have said this already, is that at the rate that we originally got it, or will that be at the 0.9?
That's at the new rate, because we have to pay for the old rate with the new money, and then another 1.4. So the new, the 5 million will be at 0.95%.
And that interest due during FY 14 then will be 47.5?
That is actually FY 15, because it's due August 7th of next year. So we have approximately 67,000 so far that's due and budgeted appropriately for FY 14. And then, I mean, it's hard to tell what FY 15 will be. We have to, if we'll do more borrowing. If we go to long-term borrowing, we'll have to do, I can't give you an interest, but as of now, it's about 95,000 just with these two borrowings.
For the next.
For FY 15.
Yeah, for the committee's benefit, the cash flow will drive your borrowing, and for FY 14 budget, all of the bands due are already accounted for. So anything going forward will be 15 and beyond, depending on when you do the long term borrowing.
Thank you.
And doing it now makes sense because the rates are lower.
Yes.
And there's
well,
a fear that in a month through.
You can't go long-term, too.
Well, we can't go long-term. But if once we have our second set of audited financial statements, that's an option to us is to go long-term. But we have to go short-term right now until we get our second set done.
Yeah.
We're just
we have no alternative but to roll over the $3.6 million. That new, that short-term borrowing is coming due. So we have
to pay
the old note with newly borrowed money, and we're borrowing an additional $1.4 million just to be sure that we don't have any shortfall between now and November.
And that's not to say we won't have to do another one before November. It depends on if they have a jump in work done, so we have to go out again.
All right, so I will first entertain a motion to approve the borrowing of $3.6 million to renew the existing $3.6 million band that is coming due.
So moved. Second.
Motion made by Mrs. Gagliardi, seconded by Ms. White. Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Unanimous. Now I'll entertain a motion to for a new short-term borrowing of $1.4 million. Have a motion to that effect?
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Camara and seconded by Mrs. Gagliardi. Is there any discussion? In the absence of discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next item on the agenda, approval of June building project requisitions. Previously, or during the week, I sent to all of the committee members the June requisitions that have been submitted by AI3 Architects, Skanska, our project manager, and our general contractor, Bacon Agostini. All of these requisitions have been reviewed by the five-member subcommittee that meets monthly to review the requisitions in detail and submit a recommendation to the building committee. The ordinary process that's been followed is that the building committee approves the amounts of the requisitions, and then it comes to us for final approval and signing of the warrant for these items. Last Tuesday, the building committee agenda included approval of these requisitions. However, there was not a quorum achieved at the meeting. There were 10 people present, 12 people were needed for a quorum. So the meeting has been rescheduled to this Thursday, at which point I anticipate that these requisitions will be approved by the building committee. If we wait until after they're approved by the building committee, then it will delay the payment for at least 2 weeks, and it's rather late in the month. These requisitions are for the month of June. So what I would suggest to the committee is that we approve the requisitions in an amount not to exceed the requisition amounts conditional upon final approval by the building committee. Yes, let me just read for the record. AI3's monthly requisition is $23,461.57. The extra services invoice, which is essentially reimbursement for contracted services, is $3,183.24. So I'd entertain a motion to approve the two AI3 requisitions in those amounts.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mrs. Gagliardi and seconded by Mr. Camara. Is there any further discussion?
Is that subject to the building committee?
Subject to building committee approval in an amount not to exceed the amounts that I read. Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. The Skanska invoice for June is $47,680 for basic services and $20,042.28 for testing and inspection services. I would entertain a motion to approve those requisitions for payment, again subject to building committee approval, and in an amount not to exceed those dollar amounts.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Kelly and seconded by Mrs. Rothwell. Any discussion? In the absence of discussion, all those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. The final invoice is the Bacon Agostini invoice for general contractor services for the month of June in the amount of $3,744,100. I would say that both the architect and the onus project manager thoroughly review the general contractor's monthly requisition. The five-member subcommittee toured the building the Wednesday before they met to consider the requisition to satisfy themselves that the progress that was reflected in the requisition was in fact in place. And this requisition was reduced by the onus project manager and architect by at least a couple of $100,000. So the amount for this month's requisition is $3,744,100. I would entertain a motion to approve payment of that requisition in the amount not to exceed $3,744,100, conditioned upon building committee approval.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Ghilarducci and seconded by Ms. White. Any further discussion? In the absence of further discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next item on the building committee update is technology subcommittee report.
From the building committee?
Yes.
I don't know, Ray, have they had any more demonstrations on the voice over IP providers?
No, we haven't moved forward with that. I did run into a vendor who does some current work and asked to be
considered,
so I just passed the name forward to Stephanie Beal.
I haven't heard of anything. The only thing I do know is that TechEdge has provided an initial report on the owner-provided list. That's something that we had asked them to help us put together. And that very comprehensive report has been drafted and sent to the committee, but they haven't had a chance to look at it and make any comments. So that is in the works, and that will help us determine how to best and most effectively spend the $1.6 million budget number in technology for that new building.
Have you received a copy of that?
No, sir.
And what did you ask me to do?
We don't have a name of that technology task force. I don't, the technology task force, I don't believe is meeting again until September, but that, I'll know on Thursday when the building committee technology subcommittee is meeting. Do you have any idea, Ray?
I don't have that. It's not, I don't have anything listed.
Yeah, I think they're gonna, they'll probably set, I know Stephanie Field is the chair. She's probably gonna talk about setting up another meeting at our building committee meeting this coming Thursday. But Ray, I'll check with her to get that draft proposal to you from TechEdge.
That'd be great. Thank you.
Since the building committee meeting didn't go forward, we didn't have a report on the progress of the technology subcommittee, but I would imagine they'll be meeting rather soon because they need to make some progress on several issues.
What time and where is the building committee meeting? It's over high school.
Yes.
Thursday?
The building committee meeting is Thursday, 6:30 at the North Elementary School. Next item is the building project update. And the building continues to move along very well. There is a substantial amount of progress being made on the interior of the building. Most of the masonry is completed in the courtyard area, which is the area that they concentrated on first, and now that they're beginning to install masonry on the facade of the building starting on the east side. The athletic field is moving along. We were assured at Friday's meeting that the field is on schedule to be turned over on, I believe, August 21st. The synthetic turf is down on the playing surface for the football field. They have to install synthetic turf around the sidelines, but that goes more quickly because it's a different type of installation. And so the bleachers are largely completed. And in fact, project supervisor is looking for the building inspector to sign off so that they can begin closing in some of the walls on the second floor, which is the area where they've made the most progress in terms of insulation of mechanical systems and electrical work. So it seems to be moving along very much on schedule. Any questions about progress? Okay. Our agenda now calls for public input. There's no public input at this time. We have an informational item. The students at the high school who were designated as students of the month for the month of June in the art department. Desiree Wrightington in the business department, Joseph Defendra. In the English department, Jillian Sargent. Engineering technology department, Megan Monty and Danielle Chubbuck. Mathematics department, Olivia Resendiz. Science department, Julia Davis. Social studies department, Brent Dismore. Wellness department, Megan Parrish and Emily Cummings. And the world language department, Christina Almeida. Congratulations to all of them. We have a joint, as we've said earlier, we have a joint meeting scheduled with the Somerset School Committee tomorrow evening at 6:30 p.m. at the North Elementary School, and our next regular school committee meeting is scheduled for August 5th, probably here at the high school. But for the information of the members of the committee, the reason that we've been meeting at the high school, I think I mentioned this at a previous meeting, is that there's no custodial staff scheduled at the North Elementary School in the evening during the summer, so there'd be an expense involved if we were to meet there, whereas here in this building, there is a custodial staff scheduled to work, so the building is open and available without any additional expense. At this time, we have an executive session scheduled, and I would entertain a motion to enter into executive session in accordance with Chapter 30A, Section 21, for the purpose of discussing strategy with regard to collective bargaining and litigation, because an open session would have a detrimental effect on the board's bargaining position or litigation position, or the litigation position of the committee. An open session will not follow.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Camara and seconded by Ms. White. Is there any discussion? In the absence of discussion, roll call. Mr. Ghilarducci?
Aye.
Mr. Kelly?
Aye.
Ms. White?
Aye.
Mr. Gagliardi?
Aye.
Mrs. Rothwell?
Aye.
And Mr. Camara?
Aye.
The chair votes aye.